All right. Hope you guys enjoyed that time lapse. Sorry I didn't do an intro before, but so it's kind of weird. You're just gonna see a time lapse, but I'm trying to do this fast. I'm a little behind. I'm trying to get up to the truck before it gets hot, but we got everything loaded. Now I'm just gonna show this kind of crazy idea I have. I don't know if it's gonna work or not, but I'm thinking it will. No reason why it shouldn't. But I'm gonna use the Rivian outlets, which we have right here. We have two outlets. I'll show you. You see, boom, outlets. So we're gonna, and this takes 110 to charge, so I'm gonna charge this on the way, and hopefully I'll have a full charge when I get up there, and I'll charge at the Rivian Center for free. So then my gas and my Rivian driving expenditure, you know, I'm basically spending nothing on gas for my bike and my vehicle because the charging at Rivian is free for now. So that is going to be hopefully how this all works out. Stay tuned. I'll show you how all this plugs in. And then, yeah, we'll take a trip up the truckie and we'll go riding on this around. See how the charger is like this. Got a nice heavy duty fan on it. Keep things from exploding and catching on fire while you're charging. Looks like we got an instruction manual here. Oh no. It's a cool little booklet with their instruction manuals in there, like right here. Yeah. I'll probably read those later. All right. Let's see. Boom. There we go. I'm gonna put this on. Boom. So this is gonna plug into here. This now can plug into my outlet. Real tricky part is going to be keeping this from sliding around everywhere. There we go. Alright, so there's the charge. Outlets. So now it should be charged. The fans are straight spinning. There we go. Those are charging. Perfect. Let's see. Let's see what the charge is. So we're at 50%. So it should be full charge by the time we get up there. Let's take that out so I don't get stoned. All right, we made it. I got the charger charging on the Ultra B. Now we're charging at the Rivian chargers. You see, we got Rivian chargers all up and down this place. Got plugged in right there, and then now we got it strapped down right there, nice and tight. It's getting a little warm. Let's see where we're at from. It's only been about 20 minutes, 30 minutes of charging. Gotta get my key. All right, so let's see how much charge we got going on here. Oh shit, got another 5%. Superchargers must be in here. There they are. We made it. So right now it's predicting 98 miles, but we actually have, hold on, let me get it. There we go. 102 miles left. And so it was pretty much right on point. It just, I was driving kind of like a maniac, flip-flopping, and I could realize that it was going to change based on my speed, because that was basically the only thing it couldn't really predict was if I was going to go the speed limit or not. But All right, so we made it with 102 miles to the Rivian Charger here in Truckee. It predicted 107 and we were only 5 miles off, so that's pretty good. I'm impressed. I was fluctuating my speed a lot. I noticed it would go down and up. Even when I go slower, it'd come back up. So it's definitely the only thing they can't predict is your speed. Now you know. Free! Man, even all the way from Sacramento to Truckee, not a dime spent except for my time and depreciation, which is a lot on an electric vehicle, depending on the one you get, which I'm pretty sure this one's not gonna do as good as a Tesla, but hey, you can't put a price on fun. That's for sure. All right, I got that. We're charging at 519 miles per hour. Woo! That's fast. All right. We made it to Boca/Prosser Reservoir. There's two reservoirs here. One's Boca, one's Reservoir. Or one's Boca and one's Prosser. Now we're getting the Rivian all dusty. Getting its first real dusty road under his belt. We're gonna go find a spot. We're gonna unload the dirt bike and get going. We're gonna show you some of these little trails, show you how the Suron runs, and see if I actually like it or not. Here we go. Just lowered the Rivian. She's lowering down as we speak. Gonna unload this bike. I'm gonna rip these trails. We found our spot. I'm gonna check on the charging. We charged the Suron the whole way. Had plenty of range with the Rivian. Now we're back up at 230 miles after charging in Truckee. Woohoo! Nice helicopter over there. Let's see if I can get it. There she looks like my risky battery situation, hold down situation, held down the whole trip. I was being pretty careful. All right, let's go check this range. Let's see here. Where are we at? Nice. So we made it all the way up to 98% in about 2.5 hours of charging and driving, maybe about 3 from 50%. Worked out. I like it. That. Come on. Open this up. Like that. All right, so I just showed you how to air it up. I actually needed to deflate it, so I was seeing if it would actually deflate. That was my original intention, but looks like it doesn't release air through that whole entire valve, which is pretty assumable. You know, no, I don't think there's really a system that really does that. You always just have to bleed it with the valve at the tire. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to lower my tire pressure, then we're going to be hit, and then I'm going to actually have to lube my chain. Then I can hit the trails after I get my gear on. Now we're at 7, so let's air it up now. 17 PSI is where I want it. Let's get in there. It's a little close, this thing ends up real quick. It popped it up from, I think it was 21 PSI it started at, and then I just pressed it for a second and it was all the way up to 34, so see, I think it might be done. Now we're at 16. It's perfect. That's all I really want. Maybe one more just for the Rockies. Man, that is nifty. I like it. Now let's check the front tire. All right, the front tire, you want around 19 PSI. So we're gonna get it right there, see where it's at. Boom, put that there so we don't lose it. Yeah, it's almost too big of a handle for this nozzle, but it's just perfect to get in the tires. If you had a bigger bike, they'd be even better. Now let's go see what this one's at. Here we go. 21. I think that's going to be good. We'll leave it at that. I might let a smidge out just to be, that's it. Next thing you know, I'm gonna put my gear on and we're gonna get out there. Should still work out. See if it fits. Oh yeah, I'm a mess. Can't stop me. Perfect. Alright. All right, now that I'm good and sweaty, let's go riding. that was my first time ever being able to actually hit the throttle. Ooh, that thing's peppy. This is gonna be fun. All right, let's go. All right, so my GoPro, I forgot the little screw that goes into the helmet mount, so I don't have any other mount to really take on with there with me. So I'll try to get some shots me ripping the trails with my phone and my tripod, but that's the best I'm gonna be able to do to show you guys riding today. I'll get another video in the future. I'm gonna be hitting trails probably every weekend, so we'll be able to get some good content of it riding, but just trust my opinion so far. It's your peppy and it's gonna be real good. So man, this thing is pretty peppy. It's really hard to get used to these front brakes, or sorry, the rear brakes being up here and not down there. Panics me every now and then. Pretty much every time I go start hauling ass and I go, I have to hit the brakes real hard. I think it's down there. So hopefully I get used to that. Man, this thing is nice in the tight trails. The instant torque, sorry, my ear pod made a noise, but the instant torque makes you so much of a better rider. I haven't rode a dirt bike in like at least 5 years or more. So it's really impressive just to hop on this and just feel even better than I was before. It's crazy. The only thing I'm getting used to still is the brakes. But the moment you get used to the brakes only being on the handlebars and no clutch, man, you can keep your feet in the same position. There's no shifting your feet. There's no RPM guessing, no guessing if I'm, you know, there's no thinking about the RPMs. There's no thinking about the gear you're in. It's just all instant power. You get in a hairy situation, you got instant power. You don't have to downshift, clutch it, do all these different things. And by then you're too late. So you don't have to think ahead as much, which is a bad thing. But it's also a good thing. So we'll keep riding. I'll try to get a couple more shots. If I don't, then hopefully you guys have enjoyed it so far. If you have, hit the like button, subscribe, please drop a comment, what else you'd like to see me do. But let's finish up this fun and let's get somewhere cool and get a beer after this. How about that? Lot of fun so far. I have no remorse. That's always good when you spend too much money. And surprisingly, the range didn't go down that far. We did about 9 miles and we started with about, I think it was like 95% or something like that, and we're down to 75%. See, we did trip total 10 miles. So we did 10 miles. Sorry, I didn't even have it focused over there. So if you look right there, we did 10 miles. And then if you look at the battery percentage, if I can get it to focus, come on. I don't know if you can see that, but just take my word for it, it says 75%. And I was doing a lot of stop, go, trying to get recording. And so there was tons of switch back in the tight trails. I had to wheelie out and spin around and do all this stuff. So it actually got pretty good gas mileage if you can compare it to a gas, or sorry, electric mileage if you compare it to a gas bike. So range is actually pretty good, pretty standard for a dirt bike, I would say. Especially when you're ripping, it could be a lot worse. You can see my knee pads already are tearing up these plastics, these graphics. They didn't really design them in mind for knee pads or racing, looks like. Already tearing the crap out of them. It's all right though. That is all right. Dirt bike's supposed to look like it's road. That was fun. Time to put everything up and go get a beer. So once again, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. We're pretty much done for today. If you really enjoyed it and you want me to do more videos, please drop a comment below. Let me know any type of things you want to know about the Suron, anything you want to know about the Rivian. I'm here to make some content for it, so willing to do a lot of different things. I'm trying to come up with my own ideas, but if you also enjoyed the content and you want to see more, really helps a ton if you subscribe, like, pushes us out to more people who maybe want to know about this stuff. And yeah, let's get people educated on how sick some of this shit is. Because for me, it's not really about the environment. It's not really about saving money. Even though those things are a benefit. Yeah, I did save money without having to spend any gas or oil or anything except for chain lube and my time. Probably a couple other things I'm not thinking of. But definitely save some money there. And we're helping the environment, I guess you could say, if you charge from renewable sources, which is what the Rivian chargers say they are. So that's pretty cool. I charged all off of that, including the bike. We charged off of the Rivian, which the Rivian was charged off the Rivian supercharger network, which is all renewable energy, they say. That's what they say, not me. But anyway, so yeah, please support the channel. Share it if you really enjoyed the content with someone you want to go Suron riding with. Share it with your dad if you want him to get you a bike. Share it with your family, you know. And yeah, appreciate you guys. Out. This is actually pretty trippy. So we got here, we parked, we had 204 miles, and now we're at 211 miles. So this thing does a real good job of underestimating. It's like it under promises and over delivers on the range. It tries its absolute best. So that's really awesome. And yeah, so I thought for sure we were gonna have a drain, probably at least a mile or two lower, but we're actually about 7 miles higher, so I'm gonna turn on the AC real fast. Get it nice and cool in here. Power that on. Boom, turn my AC seats on. That way I can get in and it'll be icy. Ooh.